This is Team Hard Life Captain Albert Tucci here. I've got another quick little video, and this one is how I use fresh life or fresh dead bait. It's live, obviously. We just caught it, and it's a sand trout. But when I cut it up to use it for chunk bait or casting bait, I do it a certain way, and the reason for it is because, have you ever had your leader get all twisted up to where when it came back it was, you know, basically you were fishing, but you weren't fishing because your leader was all tangled up. So as the leader lands and the bait hits the bottom, if there's a current out there, it starts to catch that current and starts doing windmills. Well, while it's doing that, it spins up on your leader and you bring back a tangled mess. Well, aerodynamics is kind of the way it's playing into effect with your bait. If it's not aerodynamic, it can catch a lot of water and it can twist up your leader and mess you up so you're not actually fishing. So here's a few ways that I cut up my bait and I set it up. Sorry, I'm going to be drifting off because I am still fishing. So what I like to do is I'll cut off the head. And do not throw the head away. The head is a very good bait for bull reds and small shark, and stingray is what we're also looking for. But this gullet here, what I'll do is I'll cut down and I cut that out. And the reason for it is because this actually creates a wind tunnel or a sack that will catch wind and keep your bait from flying out in an aerodynamic kind of way. So it slows down your cast and twists up your leader. And then I'll cut up my bait again. Here and here. Sometimes if there's a lot of sand trout, what I'll do is I'll make this chunk just a little bit bigger, then I'll cut that off and I'll use this to catch actually some more sand trout. Now, this sack, if you've ever seen it in a sand trout, if you actually put this on the hook and reset it back out, you're pretty much guaranteed to catch some more sand trout. So if you haven't tried, I'd give it a shot. We're gonna do that here in a little bit and I'm gonna get some bait out. So, to make this my head aerodynamic, I'm not going to hook it through the back side, I'm going to hook it through the front. And also too, what I want to do is use it to pin the mouth of my fish closed. So as I'm pushing it through, I'm actually rotating it back and forth like that. And what that allows me to do is to pull the hook through without crushing the skull. Once you crush the skull, it makes it softer, so that way the bait will actually fly off the hook when you're in cast, especially when you're trying to power it out there and get good distance. So that's a good way to get your head set up. I'm going to do a few more of the other baits and show you how I rig them up, so that way I get good distance on cast. And again, my one wire is up higher than the others a little bit where my hook is at, so it keeps the weight of my bait right up underneath my weight. Tackle industry rod and the Vexen rods are some of the other blanks that we use, or there's some of the other rods that we like to use when we're out fishing. This is a tackle industry and it's the 8150 9-foot class rod. As you can see on there, it's 8150 pound class. So It's extremely light. Actually, this weight probably weighs more than this whole setup right here. If not, it's very close. But as you can tell, I'm throwing a 9-ounce surf weight with this rod, with an MXL Raptor. And we're gonna throw some cut bait out there. Maybe we can get on some pup sharks. Now, the other portion of the video where I was showing you I was using the bait, see how I've created that? It's open here. All right. So even then, I'm going to put the skinny side forward and the fat side toward the back side. So that way, as it flies through the air, it's not catching all this wind on this side. And as you can tell, I went through both sides of the skin on it, and that'll be my bait setup for this rod.
Yeah, my LX is ready to fucking... Well, you got an LX too.
As you can see on the cast, I went over into the next gut, as well as there was no thumbing on the spool. What I was doing is walking the reel back to kind of show you how much line came off the reel from the start of the cast to now. And now we're going to go ahead and set